and this was when we had our self-imposed poverty as hippies. We didn't have any money. We didn't want any money. We had to save money for the two-drink minimum upstairs. I mean, that was a big deal. And we would go because he wanted to hear the musicians, and so did I. And then I saw the dancing, and I absolutely fell in love. That was how I started. And as Antoinette said, and others at our luncheon, there weren't teachers, really, at that time, very few. And you had to go and watch and go home and practice. And that's not a way that I would recommend actually learning anything. That's the truth. But that's what many people did at the time. And our friends, Aisha Ali, actually did teach. And Firuz Aram, who was one of the dancers at the Fez when I first went there, lived nearby, and she was kind of lonely. She had gone from another area to living near the Fez. And she said, when you're in town, just come on by, and I'll teach you anything. You know, just come say hello. So I would go often with a friend, and we would actually go into the Fez, because Firuz's house was that big, and they would be cleaning up, and we'd set up this skinny mirror and practice, put on some music, and they put up with us. I mean, they weren't that excited. They see Firuz gorgeous every night, and here she is with these people. But they put up with it. And so, in a way, I physically learned to dance at the Fez.